On October 26, 1881, Ike Clanton picked up his pistol and rifle and began roaming the streets of Tombstone, Arizona, looking for Doc Holliday or any of the Earp family. Ike was a member of an association of outlaws called the Cowboys and was also a successful cattle rustler and rancher. Ike felt that the Earp posse, Wyatt Earp, Marshal Virgil Earp, Morgan Earp, and Doc Holliday, had insulted him in the night before when he was not armed. Ike would proceed to go from saloon to saloon, threatening a fight with the Earps. One of the first people he would speak to was Ned Boyle, who was a bartender at the Oriental in Tombstone, saying, as soon as the Earps show themselves, the ball would open and they would have a fight. Ned Boyle would warn Wyatt Earp in the night of this. Wyatt, Virgil, and Doc would all be awoken by different townspeople who were warning them of what Ike was saying. All would return to sleep, not taking what the cowboy was saying seriously, thinking the situation would change the next day after Ike had sobered up. The next morning, realizing that Ike had indeed continued his drinking and saloon conversation through into the next day, the Earps without Holliday would set out to find Ike. Wyatt Earp would search down Allen Street, while Morgan and Virgil searched down Fremont Street. Virgil Earp would recall what happened next. I found Ike Clanton on 4th Street between Fremont and Allen with a Winchester rifle in his hand and a six-shooter stuck down in his breeches. I walked up and grabbed the rifle in my left hand. He let loose and started to draw his six-shooter. I hit him over the head with mine and knocked him to his knees and took his six-shooter from him. I asked him if he was hunting for me. He said he was, and if he had seen me a second sooner, he would have killed me. I arrested Ike for carrying firearms, I believe was the charge, inside the city limits. After this incident, Virgil would haul Ike to Judge A. Wallace's court for a weapons charge. Judge Wallace was not there, so Virgil went out looking for him while Morgan watched over Ike and held his weapons. After this, a large group gathered outside as Wyatt Earp walked into the courthouse with Deputy Sheriff and Clerk of Cockeyes County, Arizona Board of Supervisors, Rezin J. Campbell. Ike began his defense by saying, "You fellows haven't given me any show at all today," he thundered. "You've treated me like a dog. Fight is my racket, and all I want is 4 feet of ground." Then, turning on Morgan, he said, "If you fellows had been a second later, I would have furnished a coroner's inquest for the town," he threatened. "I will get even with all of you for this. If I had a six-shooter now, I would make a fight with all of you." Morgan reacted by angrily offering Ike his revolver, saying, "Here, take this. You can have all the show you want right now." This would cause the crowd that had gathered at the courthouse to scatter, only to return a few minutes later after realizing no shots had been fired. After this incident, Wyatt Earp would respond to Ike by saying, "You have threatened my life 2 or 3 times, and I have the best evidence to prove it, and I want this thing stopped." Then he thundered, "You cattle-thieving son of a bitch, and you know that I know that you are a cattle-thieving son of a bitch. You've threatened my life enough, and you've got to fight." He then turned and left the courtroom in a rage. As he walked out, Wyatt almost collided with Tom McLowry, who was rushing to see what kind of mess Ike had gotten himself into. Earp snapped at McLowry, and McLowry fired back, "If you want to fight, I will fight you anywhere. Are you healed? Right here, right now," Earp quickly replied. In the same instant, Wyatt slapped him, jerked his own pistol, and knocked Tom to the ground with it. He stormed away muttering, "I could kill the son of a bitch." Not known for his rage and temper, Wyatt Earp would then walk to Hartford's Corner, buy a cigar, and puff on it to calm his nerves. Soon after all of this, Frank McCleary and Billy Clanton would arrive into Tombstone. They would arrive with J.R. Frank to work on a deal in which they would provide 600 cattle to supply beef for the Union meat and poultry. After rumors began to circulate, this would lead the Earps to believe that Ike Clanton had telegraphed in Frank McLowry and Billy Clanton, which he had not. Marshal Earp would initially ask the Sheriff of Tombstone, Johnny Behan, to help him arrest the cowboys. Behan refused and responded by saying, "Don't undertake to disarm that bunch, or they will kill you. They were just down at my corral having a gun talk against you and threatening your life. I will go down to where they are, they won't hurt me, and I will get them to lay off their arms." Virgil would agree to this and later regroup with Holliday and the other Earps. Initially, Marshal Earp chose to wait for the now 5-man cowboy posse to leave. Although Tom and Frank McLowry, Billy and Ike Clanton, and Billy Claiborne were most likely going to be leaving, they did not leave fast enough. Virgil would involve Doc Holliday directly, giving him his 10-gauge shotgun he had borrowed earlier from the Wells Fargo. Sheriff Behan would first approach Frank McLowry. McLowry would refuse to give him his weapons and insisted that he did not want to fight but refused to surrender his weapons. Billy Claiborne was awaiting grand jury action from a shooting in Charleston and disassociated himself from the gang and told Sheriff Behan that he had deposited his weapons at Kellogg's Saloon for the day. Both Ike Clanton and Tom McLowry told Sheriff Behan that they were not armed, while Frank McLowry and Billy Clanton were both clearly armed. While Behan was negotiating with the cowboy group, the Earps and Doc Holliday turned off 4th Street under Fremont towards the OK Corral. Seeing this, Behan would tell the Clanton group, "I won't have no fighting. You must give me your firearms or leave town immediately." They replied by saying that they would not have any trouble. As he walked up to the Earp, Sheriff Behan would say, "Hold up, boys, don't go down there or there will be trouble. I have been down there to disarm them." The Earps misread this as if he had completely disarmed them, which he had not. He also did not intervene into the situation any further. The Clanton party was positioned in the top left corner of the OK Corral between the Harwood House and Fly's boarding house. Ike Clanton was between the two houses while the McCleary brothers stood beside the Harwood house with two of their horses which had had Winchester rifles on the saddle. The Earp posse was caught off guard by rifles in plain view and Billy Clanton and Frank McCleary wearing pistols. As the Earp posse approached, Virgil would enter the vacant lot with Wyatt right behind him and Morgan lingering on the sidewalk behind, with Doc Holliday in the far background acting as backup to the right behind them. As Marshal Virgil stepped up, he would say, "Throw your hands up, boys. I intend to disarm you." "We will," Frank McLowry said as he stepped forward and grabbed his revolver from his hip. Billy Clanton also then reached for his gun. Wyatt Earp then pulled his revolver. Virgil would then say, "Hold, I don't mean that." The first shot came from Wyatt Earp, who tore into Frank McLowry's belly left of the navel. The second shot came from Billy Clanton, who missed Wyatt. As Virgil fumbled awkwardly for his pistol, Doc Holliday with his double-barreled 10-gauge would step up towards Tom McLowry, who was moving behind one of the horses after Frank had stumbled to the ground. Ike would run up to Wyatt to be shoved away and have Wyatt say, "The fight's commenced. Go to fighting or get away." Ike then stumbled through the doors of Fly's into another vacant lot. Mortally wounded, Frank McLowry and Billy Clanton would begin firing rapidly. Frank would hit Virgil in the calf. Another bullet would hit Morgan Earp in the back, chipping a vertebrae, causing him to yell, "I am hit." The horse that Tom McLowry was behind began to buck wildly, and as soon as the horse exposed him, Doc Holliday would unload both barrels of his shotgun into Tom, knocking him to the ground with 12 buckshots in his right arm. Billy Clanton by that point had been hit twice, once in the chest and once in the wrist, and was shooting from the ground with his gun propped up on his knee. Frank would move down the lot behind the second horse, using it as a shield. After firing once, the horse would turn and run. Frank would then turn to Doc Holliday and say, "I've got you now." Doc replied with, "Blaze away, you're a daisy if you have." Holliday, Morgan, and Frank would all shoot simultaneously. Holliday struck Frank in the chest, Morgan struck Frank in the side of the head, and Frank's shot grazed Doc's hip and ripped through his coat. The two McLowrys and Billy Clanton were carried into the house on the corner of 3rd and Fremont, just past the Harwood house. Frank was dead, Tom died without speaking, and Billy Clanton told people he was murdered and told them to go away and let him die. The shootout left Tom, Frank, McLowry, and Billy Clanton dead, with Virgil and Morgan Earp wounded. 3 days later, on October 29, 1881, warrants were issued for the arrest of the whole Earp posse, with each having a $10,000 bond. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos on American history.